Hello everybody, my name is Bennett Tchaikovsky and welcome to my problem walkthrough of exercise 10-9. So in addition to buildings, we also need to be aware of capitalizing self-constructed assets. And so over here on July 31st, Amsterdam engaged Minsk Tooling Company to construct a special purpose piece of factory machinery. Construction began immediately, was completed on November 1st. So to help finance construction on July 31st, Amsterdam issued a $300,000 three-year 12% note payable at Netherlands National Bank, on which interest is payable each July 31st. $200,000 of the proceeds was paid to Minsk on July 31st. The remainder of the proceeds was temporarily invested in short-term marketable securities at 10% until November 1st. On November 1st, Amsterdam made a final payment to Minsk, and other than the note, Amsterdam's only outstanding liability at December 31st, 2020 is a $30,000, 8% six-year note payable dated January 1st, 2017. So calculate the weighted average accumulated expenditures, avoidable interest, and the total interest cost to be capitalized. So in terms of what I'm going through to go through and to capitalize interest, I'm going to do it based on the lesser of the actual interest and then versus the avoidable. For the actual interest, I took out a loan or construction loan. And this over here was for $300,000. Okay, so over here, this is a $300,000 loan, and this had a 12% interest rate. So the annual interest for this loan was $36,000. However, the amount of the interest expense is going to be for 5 months. If I borrowed it on July 31st, it was outstanding from July 31st or August 1st through the end of the year. So this is going to be 36,000 times 5/12. So my interest expense on this loan, my actual interest expense was 15,000. I also had one other than the note, Amsterdam's only outstanding liability is a $30,000 six-year note. This is 30,000. The interest rate is 8%. And so over here, my interest expense on this amount was 2,400. I don't have a partial year issue on this because this note was outstanding for the entire year. Okay, so I can just put it like this, annual interest and then interest expense, loan outstanding for full year. Okay, so my total actual interest expense is going to be 17,400. So to compute my avoidable interest, I need to determine my weighted average construction expenditures. So my weighted average construction expenditures are going to be, I immediately made a payment of $200,000 right over here on July 31st. Okay. And then on November 1st, I made another payment of another payment of $100,000. Okay. So as I look at this here though, Let's just read this really carefully. It began immediately on July 31st and it was completed on November 1st, 2020. So these are my expenditures. However, I need to figure out though, what portion of the year were these actually, I'm trying to figure out weighted average, meaning that how many months were these outstanding for? Well, this is where it gets a little tricky. Because the project was completed on November 1st, the project really was only outstanding from August 1st to from August 1st through December 31st, through October 31st, for a total of 3 months. Okay, and I'm just using the dates up by one. I'm not going to ask you for specific days of the year. So July 31st through November 1st, when the project was completed, was 3 months. Over here, because so this payment was outstanding for 3 months, this payment out here is actually not outstanding at all. We made this payment and the project was done. So this was not outstanding at all. So this is basically not outstanding. The payment was made when the project was completed. So this is a little bit more funky, but it's still, hopefully it's kind of making sense. If it doesn't, I'm sure I'll hear about it from you in class. So what I'm gonna do now is the partial period. This is gonna be 3/12. This will be 0/12. When I multiply 200,000 by 3/12, I'm gonna get $50,000. This is going to be zero. So when I, this is my weighted average construction expenditure. Be a total of $50,000. So over here, this is going to be 50,000. What I'm then gonna do is remember my rule, is that if I had a loan amount outstanding of a specific construction loan, I'm gonna be using that amount. If the weighted average expenditure exceeded 300,000, then I would have to also use this interest rate too, but that is not the case. So my interest rate is at 12%. So my avoidable interest is going to be 50,000 times 12. Now, what some of you may be asking is, Tchaikovsky, you went through up here and you multiplied this here by 5/12 because this is how long this interest was outstanding for. But notice here, I've already created the partial period. So I've already basically put this in a way that now I can go through and use the annual rate. So for this purpose here, my avoidable interest is going to be $6,000. So my weighted average accumulated expenditures is 50,000. My avoidable interest is 6,000, which is the weighted average times the interest rate that's specific to the construction loan. And then my total interest cost to be capitalized is going to be $6,000. So it's now asking us to prepare the journal entries needed on the books of Amsterdam at each of the following dates. So over here, we have July 31st, November 1st, and then December 31st. So let's just kind of go through over here. So on July 31st, I'm receiving cash in the form of the loan. So to finance construction, this was the note payable. At the same time, I gave 200,000 of this to Minsk. And additionally, what I decided to do with the to report the same time, I basically said also with this other $100,000, I turn around and purchase short-term marketable securities. Of 100,000. Okay. Okay. When it comes to the next entry. Okay, so my journal entry here for July 31st. I received the cash from the, or I issued the note. I then paid the payment to Minsk, and then I invested the short-term amount in marketable securities. Okay, so now I need to do the journal entries as of November 1st. So I made the final payment to Minsk. Okay, so right over here, cash. Construction in progress for 100,000. Okay. All right. Now, the next thing I need to go through and do, though, is that the job was finished. So I'm now going to basically call this over here. I can essentially say machinery. And then I'm going to go over here, construction in progress. And this is really construction in progress. This is going to be machinery. Machinery. And I don't want to call it directly machinery. Rather, what I want to do is I want to wait till it's finished and then essentially here, so this is now going to be 300,000, crediting us over here for 300,000. So now that it's finished. Okay. So this one here, I would call to record final payment. And this is to transfer out of construction in progress to machinery. Okay, so the last thing I'm gonna do over here on December 31st is that my interest expense for the year, or actually let's go through and do this. So the amount of avoidable interest becomes what I'm going to go through and capitalize to machinery. So over here, so I'm going to debit machinery for 6,000. The difference between my actual interest expense, or the interest expense, will be the difference between my actual. So it's the actual, which was 17,4 minus the amount that I took to construction in progress, which was 6. Okay. Now, when it comes to cash, how much cash am I paying? Well, the construction loan here is not going to be payable until July 31st. However, over here, there's this amount here, the six-year note is basically being paid every December 31st. So my crediting my cash here for 2,400, and then I'm going to be debiting interest payable for 15,000, which represents this interest, but however, it's basically my accrued interest, but I'm gonna call it interest payable because it's not being paid until July 31st of the following year. So that is the second part here for this problem, exercise 10-9. Thank you for joining me here today, and I look forward to seeing you on the next video. Have a great one.